Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, Mr. Bersin. Good to see you. I want to start by asking you about the unmanned aerial systems being operated by Customs and Border Protection's Office of Air and Marine. And as you know, their CBP has five Predator drones. I brought a nice little model of that so we everybody could see what they look like. But astonishing to me that the Department of Defense has 6,000 unmanned aerial vehicles in its inventory, and yet Customs and Border Protection, that's responsible for maintaining border security in our country, we only have only has five. And as you know, three of them operate out of Arizona, two of them out of North Dakota. And yet Texas, that has the longest common border with Mexico, has none. As you know, I've written, and I know Governor Perry has, and asked Secretary Napolitano to proceed with all dispatch to correct that oversight. And at this point, we're still waiting for the FAA to issue a certificate of authorization, because somehow they just have been unable to deal with that on what I would consider to be a timely basis. Can you tell me what the CBP has done to once that certificate of authorization is issued? Well, first of all, let me ask you, have you done anything to encourage the FAA to move on that quickly? And then I'd like for you to say, tell us what CBP's done to prepare for the issuance of that certificate so we can get a drone like this in the sky as soon as possible over Texas.
Senator Cornyn, the UAV COA that's under consideration by the FAA has been a matter of constant inquiry by us. With regard to the COA covering West Texas, there's another one that would cover the actually the sixth UAV that we have, the Guardian Maritime, that will be based in Corpus. But with regard to the land predator, the West Texas COA, it is my understanding that the legal deadline for issuance or in consideration of the FAA is coming within a couple of weeks. And in fact, we have been making regular inquiry. I have a meeting with FAA Administrator Babbitt next week, in which we will, I trust, hear good news, because it is an absolutely essential dimension of Homeland Security and will become so even more as we move into the future. So I think the other COA having to do with the Guardian, the so-called Maritime Guardian Predator, is one that was filed more recently, and we will expect the FAA in due course to consider that. But Secretary Napolitano has given direction. I was present when she met with Governor Perry, and she's committed to this, as is CBP.
Well, Mr. Bersin, I appreciate your answer. You can understand, given particularly Senator Bingaman talked about, of course, the violence occurring in Mexico and growing concerns about the spillover effects in the United States, why using the very best technology we have to provide security, both perception of security and real security at the border, is an absolute imperative. And this is something that's very, very high on my priority list, very important to me. And so I hope that this happens without any more undue delay. But I want to say it, we shouldn't stop there. I know the SBI net has been dispatched, is unworkable, and assessments being made as to what needs to replace it. We're all waiting to hear what that assessment is, because we know that the border is not secure. There are more than 500,000 people detained coming across our southern border last year, and who knows how many people actually come that are not detained and returned to their country. And we know that with the drugs, the weapons, the people being brought almost across the border at will by the cartels and other organized criminal gangs, that this is a problem that has to be dealt with a concrete plan. Which gets me to the budget. The administration has requested an appropriation of $11.17 billion for CBP for 2011, which is actually a 2.3% decrease. And in 2011, It amounts to a further decrease of $318 million. What is the plan to increase the number of boots on the ground, Border Patrol, physical infrastructure, and technology so that the American people can be assured that the federal government is doing everything it possibly can to secure the border?
As you know, Senator Cornyn, since 2004, the Border Patrol has more than doubled in size. We now have a Border Patrol force.
Mr. Bersin, I know that's good, but it's not good enough. And that's what I want to know. What do we do? What's your plan going forward?
We have worked through recognizing the fiscal constraints that we face as a nation, that we will not decrease the number of Border Patrol agents on the ground. We, in fact, will maintain the steady state, notwithstanding the attrition that you see in an organization as large as that. With regard to the ports of entry, the CBPOs will also be maintained at a level just under 21,000 officers. We will, I believe, be seeking to redress the 200 additional Air and Marine people that we need to maintain a steady state. So, Senator, I take your point. I think you would agree that we are much better resourced than ever before, that we are seeing the benefits of that. There's additional work to be done, and as we consolidate our efforts, I would expect that there will be further growth. But together with the technology, whether it's UAVs or an adaptation of SBINet, we must, in fact, combine the technology with the infrastructure with the boots on the ground.
Mr. Bersin, let me just say in conclusion, I share your concern also about making sure that our authorized ports of entry are properly resourced so that the legitimate commerce and trade, which benefits our nation as well as our trading partner, Mexico to the south and to the north, that those be improved. But I would tell you that the status quo in terms of staffing and deployment of technology when it comes to border security is not acceptable to me, and I don't think it should be acceptable to the American people. We don't cut corners when it comes to our national security, when it comes to funding the Department of Defense. We do what it takes, and the American people, I know, are committed to doing what it takes to make sure our nation is secure. And I think the same thing applies to border security. The American people are terribly upset. They're scared. They're mad. And they don't understand why we aren't doing more to secure our border. So I would just suggest that we need a plan from the Department of Homeland Security, from Customs and Border Protection, about how to get it done. And then we need a price tag, and then Congress needs to deal with that as a responsible body, because the American people simply are not going to be satisfied with flatline budgets and no more border patrol agents because of budgetary concerns. It's important, but security is more important. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator. I share your sense of urgency.
Senator Wyden is next.
Thank you, Senator Cantwell, and welcome to Mr. Bersin. And let me